So sometimes there are people who know when to call it quits, and then there are sometimes when they don't. You know, they think, oh, I'm just going to play the character forever or whatever. Hugo Weaving, love Hugo Weaving, love him as Elrond, but he's like, I don't want to be Elrond forever. I think I'm done. So Hugo Weaving, and you know, just he was so great as Elrond. He really was. You know, him and Galadriel, or Cate Blanchett. I was about to say him and Galadriel. No, him and Cate Blanchett really made, when you watched them, you really, it felt like, you know, Elrond and Galadriel, beings who were around, you know, long before anything else. So they really did a good job at kind of portraying, you know, these immortal beings who have been around for ages. So Hugo Weaving, who played Elrond in Peter Jackson's adaptation of Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit, who recently announced he has no intention to return to Middle-earth and explained why. So he said, personally, I've had enough of that. It was great being in New Zealand on and off for a 10-year period. I did then go back and work with the same team on a project called Mortal Engines, which was going to be the next their next big franchise, but it died but it died on its arse. Awesome. So I've had enough Middle Earth, and I don't think anyone would ask me to do it again. Weaving then noted that even if he did return to play Elrond, it was in the recently announced Hunt for Gollum movies. Why? It would not work given the immortality of his character and the fact that he's gotten older. Elrond is meant to be be immortal, and I'm aging. Elrond is one of the few characters, I think there's only three or four of them, who spans through the Silmarillion, The Hobbit, and Lord of the Rings. Yeah, they're incredibly old. And that's why, like I said, him and Cate Blanchett, and even Ian McKellen as Gandalf, even though they were there before him, they look feel like beings who have been around for a very, very long time. But even back when we were back to reshoot certain parts of Lord of the Rings, I was aware I was older than I was before, and shooting stuff on The Hobbit was really I was starting to get slightly silly. I love being a part of the franchise, but I have absolutely no plans or desires to be part of it anymore. I mean, like I said, you gotta know when to stop. Sir Ian McKellen. This beautiful bastard right here. This funny, charming, witty. Him and what you get him and Patrick Stewart in the same room? Oh my God. They are precious. They are. Gollum would look at that and call them precious, because they are. During an appearance on This Morning, McKellen shared, do I want to do a crappy Ian McKellen impression? Okay, well, all I know is that they called me up and said that these films were going to happen, mainly be about Gollum. Andy Serkis, who played Gollum, is going to direct, and for him, for Andy, it doesn't matter. He's the voice of Gollum. He like does the motion capture and everything. So someone like him, yeah, he can keep working on them as much as he wants, because he's not, you know, his image isn't there. You know, he's gonna be motion capture, you know, in the suit and all that, and then Gollum is gonna be created. So for him, but for someone like Ian McKellen or Hugo Weaving. Especially again, Hugo Weaving, who's considerably older now than when he first played Elrond. Now they could de-age him with movie magic, but for some reason it just kind of looks wonky sometimes. If you think of what was it? Which movie was it? The one of the Pirates of the Caribbean, the one with what Captain Salazar, where you have like a young Jack Sparrow, where it was like someone's body with like Johnny Depp's face on it, his face was de-aged to look younger, and it looked goofy. It looked goofy. Now for Hugo Weaving, I mean, sometimes it's as simple as just smoothing out some of the skin, and then there you go, you look younger. But you know. And there will be a script arriving sometime in the new year. That's next year, and I'll be the judge whether I want to go back. Because no matter what, this man is Gandalf right here. Always. If I pull a phrase from another franchise, always. He continued, but I would like to go back to New Zealand, number one, and I also don't like the idea of anybody else playing Gandalf. Yeah, I don't either. Ian McKellen is Gandalf. That's like, you know, kind of on a, like a, out there, but it's like anyone else playing Deadpool. You know, like Ryan Reynolds is Deadpool. Or anybody else playing, I don't know. I would say the Joker, but there are many good Jokers. Same thing with Batman, Spider-Man, or I don't know. Let me know another person where it's like, no, that person is that character and no one else, just no. But Ian McKellen is Gandalf, and I don't want to see anyone else as Gandalf. That's stupid. When asked if there was more than one film, McKellen shared, I'm told it's two films. I probably shouldn't be saying, but I haven't read the script, so I don't know when it is, and I don't even know where it's going to be filmed, where it'll be filmed these days. I could probably film it all in London, but I'd rather not. I'd rather go back to New Zealand. Because New Zealand is gorgeous. On top of McKellen, Andy Serkis will reprise his role as Gollum. I mean, yeah, that's... there'd be no reason not to. Gollum was always stuck with me throughout all of these years. I've done audiobooks for the trilogy, The Silmarillion and The Hobbit. So Tolkien's world has never left me in any kind of way since we left the films. And the character particularly has remained such an enormous part of my life. Maybe because every time there's a Lord of the Rings project that has Gollum, he's the dude to call. You know, even if none of the other characters are there and it has Gollum, this is the guy that you're calling up. First films and the character particulars, and so it's absolutely thrilling to be able to go back and do a deep dive into his world again, specifically into Gollum's psychology. I mean, great, but I just like, do we really need it? I don't think anyone really cares about why. We know it was the ring, it drove him crazy, and he died essentially a hero. Because, right? I mean, he may not have been intentionally trying to destroy the ring, but he did fall into the fire, which ultimately destroyed it. Because Frodo gave up in the end. I understand, oh, the evil is stronger there, Mount Doom, and it was harder for anyone to resist. Yeah, I get it. I got the concept. But... it was supposed to teach that, you know, about the corruption. It can corrupt even the best people. Lord of the Rings is. That's what it looked like at first. I said Peter Jackson's Lord of the Rings is. Lord of the Rings is. Lord of the Precious is. Yeah. Frodo that he's indeed see Gollum in Mirkwood. So we're just talking about where okay, now we're just talking about like this. Like we were talking about Hugo Weaving about how he doesn't want to be in the movie, and suddenly it's like, oh yeah, let's talk about the search for Gollum and or hunt for Gollum, whatever it's called. Whatever. But yeah, even Ian McKellen said it. Hugo Weaving was like, can I help you, Sam? Come on. Mwah. What is it, bub? What? Can I help you? What is it, bubba? Come on. We interrupt this program to bring you Sam, the Wonderful Kitty, starring Sam. Sam. Come on, bub. Yeah, he's a very handsome boy. What is it? Yeah. What? Want to say hi to everyone? You want to say hi to everyone? Come on. Sam. Yeah. How do you like that view? What? Mwah. That's a tail. Mwah. That's a tail. Yeah. I got your tail. I got your tail. Yes, I got it. Yes, I do. I do, I do, I do, I do. Ooh. What? Oh, God, you pooted. Go away. I hate when you do that. You're silent but deadly. Pootus would be proud of you, though. But yeah, Ian McKellen's like, ugh. I can't, no one else can be Gandalf. I claim the rights to Gandalf. Hugo Weaving's like, yeah, I love Elrond, but I'm getting old. I'm not doing this anymore. Kind of makes me wonder what the other ones have to say, like, you know, Viggo Mortensen, all of them. But yeah, it's a shame, but also it makes sense because, you know, you don't want things to go on for too long with the character. You know, and he was perfect as Elrond. You know, he made you feel like he was around for a long time since the Silmarillion. And he's just a cool guy. He really is just a cool guy. But yeah. So we won't be seeing Hugo Weaving popping up as our Lord Elrond in anything else. And I certainly hope they don't be like, oh, well, let's look at someone else. No. Hugo Weaving is Elrond. Ian McKellen is Gandalf. Just don't. Just don't. You don't have to keep remaking things. You really don't. We have two trilogies. We have freaking Rings of Power. We don't need any more Lord of the Rings products right now. You know, IPs and whatever, so. But yeah, let me know what you think of that. And what's your favorite role for Hugo and Ian McKellen? With if you know what I'm talking about with him and Patrick Stewart in the same room, adorable. They are absolutely adorable. Anyway, that's gonna do it for me. You guys know the drill. I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.